Is the water you use for your plants good for them? Because even if all the conditions are great for your plants, and there is only the water that is not good, you'll poison your plants. But in this video, I will show you how you can select the proper water for your plants. So here we go. Even if most of the Nepenthes can grow inside a house, the only difference with your classic houseplants would be the water your Nepenthes need. But first, did you ever thought about why these plants became carnivorous? Well, these plants live in a really poor nutrient area. So by that, I mean the substrate is really poor in nutrient, and even the water is poor in nutrient. So they had to feed from something else than the roots, as does other plants. So they managed to find the food from the leaves. So for the water, you will need a very pure water. That's why most of the time your regular tap water will be too rich in minerals and nutrients. People tend to recommend 100 ppm particles per million to grow carnivorous plants. You can be under that, but you should not go really below this 100 ppm, because if it's too rich, that can definitely kill your plants. So let's say you don't live in the proper area where the regular tap water is less than 100 ppm. The other choice you have is to buy reverse osmosis water. Usually you will find them in every superstore. People buy this reverse osmosis purified water to put in the irons. Quick tips, just check that there is nothing inside this water. It should be really pure. You absolutely don't want any perfume on it, right? The other water I recommend, and I prefer this kind of water because that's way cheaper, is the rainwater. Or if you live in Canada like me, melted snow. Depending of the season, and if it's the first rain after a few weeks, your roof will be dirty, so you don't want to keep these first liters, I would say, because they will be rich of anything, dirt, pollution, whatever. But after a good shower, the quality of your water will be quite good, actually. Mine tend to be between 40 ppm and 60 ppm. So that's good for carnivorous plants, Nepenthes, and that's my main source of water. Usually, I can look crazy, but by fall, when there is all this heavy rainy day, I will stock as much water as I can. And by that, I mean I have a lot of the 4-liter milk bottle. I keep them, I clean them, then I just fill them with water and stock them on my basement. Just make sure there is no light, because you will grow algae inside. So find a place, pitch black, in your basement, and you will have your stock. And during spring, when the snow melts, and even during winter, after a heavy snow, I will just take the last snow on the very top and make it melt, and that's really pure water. Just keep in mind that these plants really need a lot of moisture and humidity. So that's why you will consume not a lot, but still a good amount of water. So if you can find a cheap way to get this water, that's good. Hey, before showing you the water test I just did, can you do me a favor and hit the like button? That will help me a lot to build this channel. Thank you. Okay, we will do a test for the water. And you'll see that all water are not the same and they are not all good for your plants. First, what you will need is a TDS meter. This is something that will help me to show you what is inside the water. First, we will go with the tap water, 133. And now we will do the Brita, close to 100 ppm. And now we have the spring water that you can buy on any grocery shopping. See, there is more mineral, 120. These three water are not good. Now we go with the rainwater, 27, which is good. And now the reverse osmosis. I make my own reverse osmosis on my basement because I also have an aquarium. It's 6 ppm. So as you see, it's almost totally pure. And now I will show you the rainwater that you get when it was not rainy for a few weeks, I would say. Dirt pollution is on your roof, so your dirty rainwater will be 73. So it's still good for your plants, but definitely you can see a difference between clean rainwater and the kind of a dirty. If this video was useful to you, please subscribe. Make sure you hit the little bell to have all the notifications. That's the only way to make sure you will see my next video. And share this video around. Have a good day. Until next time, happy growing.